All right, let's introduce the idea of doing a material balance. We'll start with this question. If we have water entering a 2-meter cubed tank at a rate of 4 kilograms a second, and it's withdrawn from that tank at 2 kilograms a second, and we know the tank's initially half full, what kind of process is this? So in this case, we have water being put into the tank and water being taken out of the tank. If you notice, there's more water being added than there is being taken out, so eventually this process won't be able to be continuous, so it can't be 2. And then the difference between transient and steady state. Steady state says that this basically is happening over time such that there's no major fluctuations in the process. Whatever is happening on a long time scale, or at least a scale that's important. So in this process, because we have something happening that's eventually not going to be able to be maintained, it can't be steady state. So that leaves us with transient. All right. So this process is transient, and as we mentioned, it's not batch. We're not charging a tank, and it can't really be continuous as we've already ruled out, so it's semi-batch. So this would fall under a transient semi-batch process. Now, when we talk about this, we could write a picture. We should always start with a picture, and we're told that the tank is half full of water, and we have water being withdrawn. It's important to start with the diagram and label it. We have one component, that of water. We know that this volume is 2 meters cubed. We have a rate, I'm going to write M with a dot for mass flow. That's going to be 4 kilograms a second, and then mass flow, and I'll label this 2 and this 1. Is 2 kilograms per second. So we have our diagram, and we can see that if we start with a general balance, just a very overall balance, then what has to happen is whatever comes in minus what comes out, plus any water that's generated minus any water that's consumed, has to equal whatever water is being accumulated. What I've written here is what's known as a general material balance. A mass balance has to be conserved. Whatever mass goes into a system has to come out. Mass can't just be destroyed, nor can it be generated. Of course, there are some exceptions to that when we talk about, say, nuclear reactions. But for most things that you're going to see, let's just say that mass cannot be generated or consumed. We also know that if there's no reaction taking place, then a species like water can't be generated or consumed. So it all depends on how we decide to do this process. We could either write a species balance for water or a mass balance for water. In this case, they're the same thing. If we had multiple components, then we could write different species balances, and we could see some other examples that will do that. So very generally, because we don't have a reaction, and since we're working on a mass scale, we're going to say that there's no generation or consumption. So our balance here comes down to in minus out equals accumulated. Right? So if we want to figure out how long it takes to get this tank filled up, let's go ahead and go back to our material balance. We know that in minus out equals accumulated. I'll just abbreviate that. And to redraw my picture really quick. So here's our schematic and our mass balance. So at this point, we could pretty much just fill in some numbers. That'd be the next logical step. So if we write it, again, make sure we have the units down. 4 minus 2 kilograms a second out has to be accumulation. So the accumulation is going to be 2 kilograms per second. Now, if we convert this to a volume, we are going to need some kind of conversion factor. The conversion factor from volume to mass is density. A nice way to remember this, I always kind of go back to a triangle. We know that density has to equal mass to volume. So depending on which one you need, you cover that up and you could do the calculation with what you have. So in this case, we have mass, we need volume, so we're going to take mass and divide by density. So 2 kilograms per second divided by the density of water, which is 1 kilogram per liter, is going to give us 2 liters per second. However, we're not working with liters, we're working with meters cubed, so this is going to be 0.002 meters cubed per second, because there is 1,000 liters per meter cubed, and we're going to divide by that to cancel out our liters and get meters cubed on top. We have 0.002 meters cubed per second. We know that we need to fill 1 meter cubed until this tank is full. That's the empty space. So in this case, we could write an integral balance where volume is going to be the volumetric flow rate times some time interval. In this case, we write this out, 0.002 meters cubed per second dt, and we know 1 meter cubed equals 0.002 meters cubed per second times t. So t is going to equal 500 seconds. So that's what's called an integral balance. If we were trying to figure out the rate instead, then we would probably perform what's known as a differential balance. That would give us allow us to do a balance equation to figure out the rate of input, the rate of generation, and so forth. So that's a very simple material balance. Hopefully that gives you an idea that we should always start with the picture, then move on to our general material balance, and then we can start filling in our information and solving for what we need. Again, the question was, how long does it fill up? We checked that. We have our time of 500 seconds.